Should I update to Windows 11? January 2025 update. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. So with the countdown to Windows 10's end of support approaching, my answer to the question has actually shifted. Up until now, there really hasn't been a compelling need to upgrade. And to be clear, nothing's really changed, other than the amount of time left. So it's time to start thinking about it. Now, before people take this the wrong way, I am in no way saying that you must upgrade to Windows 11. I'm going to recommend that you do so if you can, but that's all it is, a recommendation. As I have said in multiple places, multiple times, Windows 10 will keep working beyond its end of support date. You'll need to take on a little more responsibility for your security, and eventually, though not immediately, some of your third-party applications may also end their support for Windows 10. But if you don't want to, or you can't upgrade to Windows 11, you can keep on and carry on in Windows 10. Windows 11 is now approaching 4 years old. It's actually a fine version of Windows. I've been using it almost daily since the day it was released, and I've been very happy with it from the start. I have it on both my primary desktop and my laptop. Honestly, to me, it feels more like what we used to call a service pack to Windows 10, a major feature update. Honestly, it feels more like Windows 10 SP1, right? Service Pack 1, what we used to call a service pack, a major feature update, than a completely different version of Windows. Yeah, the taskbar was moved and there's some different look and feel to it for sure, but it's pretty much the same operating system. Honestly, there's very little that I had to get used to when I switched. It just kept on working. Until now, though, my take was that Windows 11 rated a big eh. There just wasn't anything really compelling. However, since Windows 10's end of support is getting closer, I think it's time to consider a switch, as long as your hardware supports it. Yep, those hardware requirements can be frustrating. Many machines, even some newer ones, fail the compatibility test. There are workarounds for some issues. For example, you may not be able to update a Windows 10 machine to Windows 11, but you may still be able to perform a clean install of Windows 11, even if the machine doesn't meet Windows 11 minimum requirements. There are also workarounds for installing Windows 11 if your machine isn't up to the requirements. Microsoft has disabled many of the previous workarounds, and it's possible that these will be disabled as well at some point. Microsoft has also indicated that machines updated to Windows 11 by bypassing the hardware requirements may not receive updates or have other issues that Microsoft won't address. We'll see. However, if you've got a new machine, it's likely to come with Windows 11 pre-installed. Keep it. Like I said, it's fine. There's no reason to run away from Windows 11. I use it every day, and it's a fine operating system, just as fine as Windows 10. I always address the so-called every other version curse. This is not a reason to avoid Windows 11, but it is at least interesting. Here's how it goes. Windows XP was popular. The next version, Windows Vista, not so much. After that, Windows 7, quite popular. Windows 8 and 8.1, not so much. Windows 10, on over a billion machines, the most ever. Very popular, still. Windows 11? It remains to be seen. It's as much superstition as it is anything else, and by itself, it is not a reason to avoid anything, particularly since there's been no word about something after Windows 11. Now, to say that Windows 11 elicits strong opinions in some is perhaps an understatement. I want to address some of the more common ones. Everyone hates Windows 11. No. In fact, a lot of people like it. Here's the thing. You're only likely to hear from those people experiencing issues. They're looking for help, or they're just venting in the various public forums that you might run across. The people who like it, the people for whom it's working just fine, they're just quietly getting on with their work. I'm convinced that there are way more of them than there are the haters. Microsoft is evil slash spying slash scanning slash whatever. You know what? That's not a Windows 11 problem. I know that some feel that Windows 11 has somehow worse in the Microsoft is evil kind of way, but personally, I don't see it. It's Windows 10 that introduced many of the telemetry settings that people complain about. To the best of my knowledge, Windows 11 hasn't made that, or anything else, worse. Windows 11 pushes things on me that I don't want. It's always been like that. Seriously, every version of Windows included features and functionality that many, though again, not all, people objected to. Sometimes people grew to like the features. Sometimes the features kind of quietly disappeared after a while. In addition, many of the current complaints aren't about Windows 11, but about the specific features that are being introduced, and often pushed hard, across both Windows 10 and 11. It's not Windows, but the features themselves that are worthy of your ire. Microsoft is colluding with hardware manufacturers to force us to buy new machines. Oh, hell no. Honestly, this conspiracy theory frustrates me to no end. No one is forcing you to purchase a new machine. Stick with Windows 10. Switch to Linux. Use one of the hardware requirement bypasses. None of those require you to spend a dollar. Yeah, eventually you're likely to get a new machine. Not because anyone forced you to, but because it was time, just as it always eventually becomes time since PCs were invented. As a side effect, you'll have a machine that meets the new hardware requirements. But nobody's forcing you to do it now. You're just a Microsoft shill. I have to include this because I often get accused of being on Microsoft's payroll, which I haven't been for decades, or I've been getting paid to endorse them. Again, I have yet to see a check, or some kind of Microsoft apologist. When I recommend that you consider Windows 11, it triggers the anti-Microsoft crowd something fierce. I consider myself a pragmatic realist. I have lots of complaints about Microsoft and about Windows. Lots. But I also realize that leaving Microsoft and Windows behind isn't in the cards for many people, including most of my audience. Railing against all of Microsoft's evils, and I agree, there are many, that just wouldn't be helpful. Helping people switch to something else would benefit only a small portion of my audience who are willing and able to do so. Instead, I try to help people make informed decisions and work with the system they have. Bottom line, think about it. Think about moving to Windows 11. If your machine can run Windows 11, the PC Health Check app will tell you, then it's time to consider what you'll do next. We're several months away from Windows 10's end of support, so you have a lot of time to experiment and decide. Your options. 1. Upgrade to Windows 11 now and start getting used to it. Revert to Windows 10 if you can't stand it or have other issues. 2. Wait. Upgrade to Windows 11 when the time gets closer. 3. Wait. Upgrade to Windows 11 when you get a new machine that comes with it pre-installed. 4. Stay with Windows 10. And of course, 5. Use this as an excuse to switch to Linux. Whatever your choice, make absolutely certain you take a complete system image backup prior to changing anything so that you can revert to what you have now if something doesn't work out. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/135037. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.